Welcome everyone to the New Hope Children's Thriving Art Worship.
And thank you for joining us. It is so good to see you guys out there. Well, unfortunately, we cannot see you, but you can see us, and hopefully we'll get to see you again soon in person. And we thank you for joining us here in our virtual studio. We have an awesome program planned for you, and we hope you enjoy. So before we get started, let's go ahead and bow our heads for prayer.
Bow your heads and close your eyes for prayer. Thank you for this. Thank you for another Thanksgiving at this time. Thank you for letting us some time with our family. Please come again soon. Please help the COVID-19 go away so we can go back out to church and see our friends and family. Please help us to enjoy this program.
Amen. Thank you so much, Elise. So, today in the program, in our studio here, we have with us, and my name is Miss Rita, as many of you will call me. All right, so let's go ahead and get started with our program, and I'm going to play a couple of songs for you, and I hope you enjoy.
To my shoulders, my knees, to my toes, I praise the Lord every day. With my eyes and my ears, my hands and my feet, I praise the Lord every day. With my mouth talks, I will praise the Lord. When my feet walk, I will praise the Lord. With a smile, to my shoulders, my knees, to my toes, I praise the Lord every day. My eyes and my ears, my hands and my feet, I praise the Lord every day. When my mouth talks, I will praise the Lord. When my feet walk, I will praise the Lord. With a smile on my face,
I will praise the Lord every day. All right, here is another one, and we hope you enjoy this one too.
What's that noise? Who's crying?
I don't know. Where's it coming from, Cindy? Sounds like over there from that old songbook.
Jason, it's coming from the book.
That's silly. Books don't cry.
Well, this one does.
Maybe it's got a name. Excuse me, Mr. Songbook? Do you have a name?
Yes.
He talks.
He really talks.
What's your name?
Salty.
Salty, why are you crying?
Because nobody'll sing my music. They just tossed me off in the corner and they forgot all about me.
We'll sing your music.
Yeah, we'll sing your songs, won't we?
Yeah.
But I'm a kid's songbook. I need kids to sing my song.
We're kids.
You are?
Yeah, but how do we start?
Well, this might sound silly, but first you need to think happy thoughts about Jesus.
Happy thoughts? About Jesus?
Yeah, like he's your Lord and Savior, and he loves you so very much.
He loves me?
Yeah, he loves you.
He loves me, yeah.
We're gonna sing.
You're doing it. You're doing it.
Praise the Lord.
Wasn't that awesome? I thought that was a pretty cool song. All right, so let's go ahead and move forward with our program. And right now, Elise is actually going to read our Bible verse for today, which is taken from Psalms 100.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. the Lord of gladness. Come before his presence. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Psalm 100.
Yes, that's the entire chapter of Psalm 100. Yeah, it's 5 verses. Yes, it's a psalm of thanksgiving. And you know, there's so many Bible verses out there that talk about giving thanks, but we're just going to stop with this one for now. So, of course, what do you think we're going to be talking about today?
Thankful.
Yes, and we're talking about being thankful. What was yesterday?
Thanksgiving.
Yes, it was Thanksgiving. Now, Thanksgiving is just one of those holidays where a lot of people, they like to get together and eat food, family and friends and play games and so many different things. So giving thanks, now I want to remind you now that giving thanks is something that we should be doing all the time. All right, we should be doing this every single day. So I want you to think about something else. How often do you say thank you? Did you say thank you to your parents this morning for making breakfast? Did you say thank you to your teachers for teaching you something new? Did you thank your brother or sister for helping you clean up? Let's see, what else? Did you thank God for waking you up this morning? And then another thing to think about, we are now going through this, dealing with this pandemic, the coronavirus. And there's so many people who have gotten sick. And unfortunately, there's so many people who have died. So did you thank God for keeping you healthy? And did you thank God for keeping your family members healthy as well too? There's so many things that we can say thanks and give thanks for. All right, so these are just a few things that we can start with, but there are many, many more. And I want you to think about it, all right? So, before we move on, we have some special guests joining us today. All right. Hi, T. Hi, Flame. Say hi to T. Say hi to Flame.
Hi.
Hey. Hey, Tay.
What, Flame? Why do turkeys go gobble gobble? Want a hint? No, I do not want a hint.
You're getting cold, Tay.
Well, I still don't want a hint. You might as well just tell me why.
Because they have terrible table manners.
That was a terrible joke, Flame.
You think so? I thought it was a good joke.
Well, it wasn't, especially with Thanksgiving right around the corner.
Around the corner? I thought it was on Thursday.
You know what I mean.
Oh, well, I do love Thanksgiving.
Really? I thought you only liked Christmas.
Yeah, Christmas too. But Thanksgiving has so much meaning.
Yes, it does, Flame. But I didn't know you knew that.
Yeah, it means turkey, stuffing, mashed potatoes, gravy, candied sweet yams, pumpkin pie, and my personal favorite, cranberry sauce.
I think it has more meaning than just food, Flame.
Yeah, there's also football.
No, I meant something other than that.
What else is there? Christmas is still a month away, you know.
No, I don't mean Christmas either.
Okay, so what are you talking about?
I'm talking about what Thanksgiving is really all about.
You are confusing me. I already told you what Thanksgiving is all about. Food and football. What else is there?
Why do you think it's called Thanksgiving?
Too easy. It's called Thanksgiving for all the thanks we're giving for the food and football.
Okay. That may be part of it, but I think there's more to it than that.
What do you mean, more to it than that?
I mean, we are giving thanks to the Lord for all of the blessings of the year.
Yeah, like foot.
Don't you dare say football and food again.
Okay, I won't, but I don't understand your point.
It's an old story. It dates back hundreds of years.
Well, I hope it doesn't take hundreds of years to tell.
It doesn't. And I can give you a really short version.
I think Tay's going to tell us anyway, don't you? Okay, go ahead.
The first Thanksgiving was in Charles City, right across the river from Hopewell.
Really?
Yes. The settlers were thanking the Lord for their survival. Everyone got together and had a huge feast, and they thanked God for all of their blessings.
And after they ate, they sat around the campfire and watched football? I know the Dallas Cowboys were playing.
No, Flame. They didn't have football teams back then. They didn't have TV either. And come to think of it, they didn't have electricity either.
No electricity?
Nope, not one bit.
Well then, I know what I'm thankful for.
What's that, Flame?
I thank God that we have electricity and TV and football games.
That's kind of selfish, don't you think?
Oh, you're probably right. Here, what I'm really thankful for, I thank God for your friendship and for the boys and girls who are watching us right now.
Well, that's more like it, Flame. And I'm thankful that God gave us Jesus to save us all.
Hey Tay, what side of a turkey has the most feathers?
I don't know, Flame. Which side?
The outside, silly. Bye, boys and girls.
Oh my God. Goodbye for now, boys and girls, and we hope you had a nice Thanksgiving.
Oh man, that was awesome. Thank you so much, T, and thank you so much, Flame. And by the way, Flame, your joke made me chuckle. I thought that was funny. Both of them were really cool. So this is a special time of year, all right? And this week, we did celebrate Thanksgiving. Now, Thanksgiving, it is one of my favorite holidays, too, for so many reasons. I get to spend time with friends and family. Yes. I get to eat lots of good food. And we all know I love to eat. I love to eat. I love food. I love food. I love good food. And I do watch football too. However, Thanksgiving is more than just that. Just like what T and Flame were just talking about, we have to give thanks to God for all of his blessings of the year, right? Right. And yes, Thanksgiving holiday is a time for people to come together and eat and play games and watch football, but most importantly, we get together and we give thanks. Now, I want you to understand something. We should not only give thanks on Thanksgiving. We should be giving thanks all the time. So let's watch and see what Douglas has to say.
Happy Thanksgiving. Hey guys, it's me again, Douglas. And Thanksgiving is one of my very most favorite holidays. Yeah, it's awesome because, you know, you get to be with family and friends and there's all this delicious food and you spend a whole day thinking about all the things that you are thankful for. And there's a lot of things to be thankful for, but my least favorite thing about Thanksgiving is we always go around the table and everybody has to say what they're thankful for this year. And every time it comes to me, I'm always drawing a blank. I can never think of what to say. And it's not like I'm scared to talk to my family. You know, they're my family. I talk to them all the time. And it's not also not like I don't have things that I'm thankful for. I know I've got lots of things to be thankful for. I just can never think of them in the moment. And I was thinking about that. I was like, you know, why is it so difficult for me to say what I'm thankful for? Well, I'm pretty sure that the reason is because I'm out of practice. You know, the Bible says that we should rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances. Basically, that's saying that you know, how on Thanksgiving we spend that day to remember what we're thankful for. That verse is pretty much saying that we should do that all the time. It should be a part of our daily lives to thank God for all the things that he has done for us. Like all the time, every day. Anytime you notice something that God has done for you, thank him for it. Doesn't have to be out loud. God can hear you even if you don't talk out loud. But even just in your head, say, God, thank you for my friends. I had a really good day today. Or even little things like if you're eating a delicious Twinkie, you can say, Lord God, thank you for Twinkies. And please help me not to eat this whole box. And here's the thing. If we start thanking God for everything that we see, everything that we're grateful for, right when we're grateful for it, and we start looking for things that God has done for us and we can rejoice and thank God for those things, I'll bet you'd be surprised at how many things you and I have to be grateful for. And I know it kind of sounds like a chore to be like, oh, I just got to thank God all the time, thank him for this, thank him for that all the time, all the time, all the time. It's not really a chore at all. You know, the next part of the verse where it says, you know, rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances. The next part it says, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. God isn't like demanding that we give thanks all the time for him because he needs us to thank him. God wants us to give thanks all the time because he knows that it's good for us. You know that great feeling that you have on Thanksgiving, where you're sitting back and you're thinking about all the awesome things God's done for you? You can have that feeling every day. It can be Thanksgiving every day. I don't care what, if it's in the spring or the summer or what. Every day can be Thanksgiving because we can give thanks every day. And I'll bet that if you're thankful every day and you talk to God about what you're grateful for, then when it comes time for you to say your favorite thing that you are thankful for this year at Thanksgiving, you'll totally have an answer. Easy peasy. And so my challenge to you guys today is that you would give thanks every day. That you would rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances. Not just so that you can have something to say at Thanksgiving dinner, but so that you could live in the fullness of the awesome life that God has called you to.
That was a pretty good reminder. Douglas had made some really good points there, all right? And now, look, let's think about some people in the Bible, all right? Let's think about some people in the Bible who gave thanks. Now, you read the book of Psalms, right? You read Psalm chapters 100. Now, who was one of the writers of the book of Psalms? What's his name? Yes! Yes, David. He's confident. Yes, David wrote many of the chapters in the book of Psalms, and he gave thanks a lot. He gave thanks a whole lot. Even when he killed Goliath, he gave thanks. Let's think about, let's see, who else was there? Oh, remember the story of the lepers? Remember the story? Yes.
Only one came back to me.
Exactly. Now, we don't want to be like those other nine. We want to be like that one. That one came back and he said thank you to Jesus. We want to be like that one leper.
Probably the other nine were so happy that they were thankful.
You know, probably they were, but we have to remember to be grateful and we have to remember to give thanks. I mean, we can be so happy, but we still have to give thanks. It's something that we have to practice doing. That's why I was asking you at the beginning, do you thank your parents? Do you thank your teachers? All right, you have to remember to be very thankful, to be very grateful. And then also, there was the story of Hannah. Remember Hannah? When she was praying for a son, and she had the son, Samuel, remember? And so she prayed and prayed, and she wanted this son so bad. And God gave her that son, and she was thankful. She was very thankful that God had given her the son, Samuel. That's the story with Samuel and Eli. Remember when Samuel kept hearing his name in the middle of the night, and he kept going to Eli? So I'm just reminding you guys of that story. So that's that story. And lastly, who was the most important person who gave thanks all the time? Who's the most important person? Who gives thanks all the time? Yes, Jesus gave thanks. Jesus gave thanks when he was surrounded by all of those hungry people and he had to feed them. He fed them with the 5 loaves and the 2 fish. And he gave thanks when he prayed and blessed that food. And he also gave thanks before he raised Lazarus from the dead as well too. Jesus gave thanks when he broke bread and drink from the cup of the disciples. All right? Jesus gave thanks many, many times. There was a lot of thanksgiving in the Bible. All right? So let us remember, like Douglas said, let us remember to rejoice always. That's actually a text in the Bible. Never stop praying and give thanks at all times. Thank God for your parents. Thank God for your food. Thank God for being able to breathe. Thank him for being able to see and hear things and to learn so that you can grow. We have to be thankful for all of these things. You can thank him for your toys. Thank him for your brother and sister, even though your brother and sister may get on your nerves, all right? Thank God that you are healthy. You can thank him for anything. Now, before we go, we had a couple of children who wanted to say what they're thankful for. So let's check them out.
Happy Sabbath, people. My name is Fabian, and I'm 9 years old. I am thankful for having Jesus in my life, and I'm thankful for having family. And I'm thankful for having a bed to sleep on. And I'm thankful for having a great life because my family are kind and when I'm struggling, they always help me with what I'm struggling with. And I'm thankful. I'm also thankful for having a great life.
Some of the things that I am grateful for are having all of my limbs so that I can walk around and do things on my own. Another thing I am grateful for is attending a great school and being able to get a good education. Another thing that I'm grateful for is having God to be all the answers to my problems.
I am thankful for my parents and my daddy and shelter. I am thankful for a house and food and family,
food and video games. I'm thankful for God and the sunshine.
I'm thankful for my family, my house, my school, food, and sleep.
I am thankful for my heart, my family supporting me and loving me.
I am thankful for a Nana who is working and helping and caring for us. And I am thankful for a roof over our head. I am thankful for online school. I'm thankful for my Nana, Raquel, Dawson, Daddy, and Mom. I'm thankful for my toys, and I'm thankful for my house, and I'm thankful for everything.
Hi, my name is Elise, and I am thankful for my parents and the house and all the food in the shelter that I have so I can live, and I'm thankful for God mostly.
Hello, my name is Devin Martin. And while we're in the season of Thanksgiving, I am most thankful and grateful that God has protected us all throughout this horrible pandemic.
Thank you guys for joining us, and thank you for sending in all of your Thanksgivings. It is so awesome to see everyone and to hear all of this wonderful Thanksgiving. So we have to remember to be thankful. I want to be thankful. Don't you want to be thankful? Don't you want to be thankful? All right. So we are going to be thankful. And here's a little reminder.
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. To think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise.
Be thankful. I want to be grateful. We serve an amazing God who deserves our praise and thanksgiving. I want to thank you all for joining us this evening, and we hope you enjoyed this program, and I hope you continue to give God thanks all the time. All right? Are you going to do that for me? Are you going to do that? You're going to give God thanks all the time? Are you going to give God thanks all the time? Yes, you are. All right. All right. We're going to give God thanks all the time because he's an awesome God and he deserves our praise and thanksgiving. Let's bow our heads for prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for all the kids who joined us and who are, and those who were unable to join us as well. We hope that this video will be able to be shared and spread to others, and others will be reminded of how awesome you are and how we should always give you thanks. Thank you for being such an awesome God. You have given us so much, and we don't want to take any of these things for granted. everything from breathing and being able to walk and having clothes to wear, being able to eat and having family and friends, and our hands can work, our eyes can work. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you. Please bless us as we get ready to begin the Sabbath, and bless everyone who is watching and even those who are not watching and everyone who is represented. In your name we pray. Amen. All right. Bye, everyone. Have a good day. Have a good evening. Bye.